The ultimate broaches tier list. Fresh tropical.
Perfect combo.
Doesn't give me kikibish. Your life will change forever.
Wifey material.
More exotic.
This is Belgian culture.
It's so good.
Hi everybody, welcome to a new video. Today is a very special day because we're going to fulfill the tier list of Belgian food culture. We have done coffee cooker, friture, and now the lunch culture. We're going to do the ultimate broodjes tier list. Broodjes are baguettes. We eat baguettes with at least 50 different salads. I'm talking about kip curry, kip Hawaii, kip piquant, American, Martino, and other things. So we're going to do the tier list. Sometimes when you go to Brussels, all you see is tourist traps. Here's a waffle. Nobody gives a shit about waffles, okay?
Waffles.
We give a shit about broodjes, coffee cooker, friture, but not about goddamn waffles. This is Belgian culture, okay? And if anybody ever dares to tell you different, I will give a baguette on his bakkes.
Well said.
So this is the smulhersje. Typical broodjes sack, as we say.
Hello, hello.
Cheers. Smulhersjes.
I love this.
Leesla.
Leesla. Meat salad.
They call it salad, but there is no salad.
It's just sauce.
We're gonna order the 25 best breads in the broodjes sack.
Oh my god.
Alright, so keep curry,
keep Andalou,
keep Hawaii, keep Samurai, Martino, my extra American.
Eiersla.
Tonijnsla.
Stampinlo.
Tonijn piquant. Surimisla. Roast beef bernese.
Smoske.
Oh, smoske. Balken. Ah, vleesla. Oeh, classic.
Broodje saxofoon. Broodje Hawaii.
Broodje Paris.
En ook een broodje porky.
More baguette. This is so Belgian.
Thank you, man.
It's happening. Let's check the rules first, of course. We've done the friture tier list, and this is just like the bread variant. So, we got Godlike, is like the best in the world. Very good. Almost the best in the world. Good. If someone comes at you and they give you a good broodje, you're like, thanks. Then you have average. If you get it for free, you eat it. Then we got meh. If you're very hungry and someone gives it to you, you will eat it, but you will not enjoy it as much. Bad. If someone comes to you and tells you you want this broodje, you're like, what's your problem?
Take it as disrespect.
And then you've got trash. If you come at me with a trash as broodje, I'll be like, wanna fight?
Oh damn, I'm scared.
Alright, let's start. The first one, kip curry, a classic. I grew up eating kip curry. It's cheap, you can buy it in kilos. And we were four kids at home. Mama made like sandwich kip curry every motherfucking day.
It's a classic.
Everybody in Belgium has eaten chicken curry, even if you're vegetarian.
Yeah, it's a rule, you have to.
Oh, one more rule. The highest rank somebody of us gives is the rank that it gets. In case I say good and Anno says very good, it's very good. Chicken curry is like
very good.
Kip curry. Now we're gonna go to chicken samurai. Chicken mixed with samurai sauce. More exotic.
A little risky.
But that's okay. For me, it's very good.
Mm-hmm, very good.
This is eiersla. Egg salad. Again, as you can see, nope. Where is the salad? I had an egg salad period in my life.
Me too.
And then I got like a little bit of a dehu. For me, it's good.
It is good.
Eiersla.
Ate it too much.
Okay, next one. Vleesla. Meat salad is jambon mixed with tartare sauce. We love sauce. We love meat. Why don't we just mix it together?
Perfect combo. For me, this is average.
I understand. Vleesla.
Merci pour le smoze.
Baguette, which look like a vagina, to be honest.
I'd fuck it.
Voilà, see? Okay, so we upped our studio a little bit. We've got a baguette behind us. Why is your lievelingsbroodje?
Scampi.
Look.
Scampi look. Oh. Let's taste scampi look. The favorite of Mener with the blue hemp. This garlic sauce with scampi. Shrimp. I have never ordered in my life scampi look, and I must say, I feel a lot of regret.
Wow!
Damn, this is actually very good.
Yeah, it's very good.
Scampi look, damn!
Damn, that was good.
Tuna and piquant. This is called spicy tuna. So it's like tuna salad, but spicy. It's all nice.
I wouldn't buy it.
No, tuna salad is like you are really good, but you're competing in F1 against Red Bull, Mercedes, and Ferrari. You're good, but you're so unfortunate that you are surrounded by epicness.
It's very good, but there's so much better.
They should have existed in a different era, you know? So I would say average.
Yeah, average.
Tonijn piquant. What is your favorite broodje?
American.
Oh, I love it.
American brings people together.
Saxophone.
Yeah. Mozzarella.
Smosh.
Poulet curry.
Oh, oh keep curry.
Club. Keep curry, yeah.
What does broodjes culture mean to you?
It means happiness. Love.
I'm
so inspired right now.
If you want to take one of these, you can. It's on a piquant, yeah?
Thank you, my friend.
Where would you put it?
It's average.
Yeah, we also had it. Yeah. What would you put Kip Curry?
It's my childhood, so yeah, it's like very good.
Oh, you also had it. Everything you will say here is 100% accurate.
Coming from a half Brit, half French, half Belgian, I think it's right, yeah.
Whoa, you're 150%.
100%.
That's crazy. This guy is superhuman. Next up is the salsa porky. I've never seen it. We got an extra because why not?
There's peach, ketchup, mayo, salad, pork.
I love myself some peaches.
If you listen closely, you can hear like salsa dance. I really love fruit mixed with meat. It's fresh, tropical, but
it's weird though.
It doesn't give me like kikibish. It's average.
It's average.
Okay, salsa porky, average. Let's go for another chicken.
Yeah.
Keep Hawaii. Remember when us Europeans decided to completely destroy Italian culture with a pizza Hawaii?
Yeah.
We decided to destroy the French culture and add some pineapple to the baguette.
I love it.
The only problem is they don't really care and it was not as efficient as the pizza Hawaii. Let's check what we got here. Chicken.
Bananas.
Pineapple or ananas mixed with cocktail sauce or something like that. I don't really like pineapple that much.
It's just weird on food.
It's still nice.
I think it's average.
I think it's average. But that's the thing, if you want to be taken seriously, I know, we need to take risks of kicking people against the shins.
That's true.
The whole Belgian food culture relies on this list. I can already see the stock markets of tuna plummeting. So this is called surimi. It's like fish, but it tastes like crab. They use it as an alternative for crab because crab is crazy expensive. Crab is for the bougie people. I like this. Surimi is good.
It's good.
Surimi. Okay, so next up, Kip Andalus. Open it up, please.
My baby mama. Will you eat my baguette?
It's like chicken mixed with sauce Andalus. Andalus, for a very long time, was my favorite sauce in the whole wide world. But now I've evolved into like the more sophisticated taste, like Yopi.
His palate evolved, you know.
Yeah. Very good.
For me, it's good. It's not better than Ayasalado.
Honestly, I will go for good also.
Yeah?
Kip Andalus. Okay, then the last one of the plateau. Gerookte zalm salad. Smoked salmon salad. But as you can see, again,
no salad.
Where's the salad, bro? Not my favorite. This might be my first meh.
Meh or bad?
Meh or bad?
I would like lightly be offended when somebody gives me that.
Let's put it on meh because if I'm hungry and someone would give it to me, I would eat it. Because if it would be bad, I would punch him.
Okay.
The plateau is empty. We've had 12 different choices. Let's go for the next 12 because broches are amazing. I don't know. This is a specialicus. So round one was more like the basics. They call it salads. And now this is called the special. Okay, so the first one is a martino. You have different ways to make martino. This is the sophisticated way. Onions, martino sauce, pickles, some mustard on the down low. And then American is like ground beef, but it's raw. So every time you're risking salmonella.
And we love the
risk. And we love the risk. Sometimes people make martino. You know, with anchovies. I'm like, the fuck, where you from? I don't need even need to taste it to tell you that it's godlike.
What a great starter.
It breaks my heart knowing that people visit Belgium and do not experience this. I'm like, you cannot get more Belgian than this. Listen, if you come into Brussels, don't you dare buy motherfucking waffles, okay?
What the fuck? I'll hit you in the balls.
If you come to Belgium, you go to a village outside of tourist trap Brussels and you order a martino and your life will change forever. You will want to sell everything you have in your home country, leave your family, your wife, your husband, your kids, come live here next to Brochesac so you can order a martino every fucking day. Oh, I'm squirting. Sophisticated martino, I love it. Next one is called a smos. Why do they call it smos?
It's messy, not Ronaldo.
Suey!
The word smos comes from like smosse, which means you're making a mess.
One tranche de jambon, second tranche de jambon,
fromaggio,
a lot of eggs, tomatoes, and salada. We actually have salads now.
So this is healthy. It's godlike. If you don't like smos, there has to be like percentage in your DNA that is not Belgian. It's so difficult to put into words the emotions I feel about this.
If you have the same feeling with a girl that you have with a boyke, marry her.
That's wifey material. Okay, let's go to the next one. This one is called saxophone because it has filet de sax.
With a lot of mayo.
The saxophone was invented by
Josh Sax.
Almost.
Josh Saxophone.
Other front name.
Baptiste Saxophone.
He has a very controversial first name.
Adolf.
Yes, his name is Adolf Sax, but it was pre-Adolf era. 1846, Adolf Sax invented the saxophone. And at that moment, while he was busy inventing, he was also eating baguette.
With
AKA
de
the saxophone with filet de sax. It's like a smoss, but more like a fancy smoss.
It's good, but a smoke is like 10 times better.
Good.
It's
okay, okay. The next one is called panis.
I feel like it's...
What does it say?
Panis.
P-A-N-E-S.
Panis. This one is the panis.
I feel like it's an Italian guy or woman who had crazy sex with a Belgian with a kinky French kiss.
It has like salami on it. Brie. And then just mayo or stuff like that.
A lot of mayonnaise. That's key. It's good.
It's good.
I'm gonna say very good.
Very good.
Panis.
So I just went inside and talked very confident about the panis.
Panis, yeah.
And she was like, huh, the what? It was like the panis. And she said, no, it's the Paris.
Ah, ah, it's an R.
Oh, it's a Paris.
Yeah.
But now that I know it's French, I'm gonna put it on trash. Tonentino.
Tonentino. Martino.
Yeah. Oh, what the fuck? Oh. It's like a Martino, but with tuna instead of American.
I'm gonna buy it.
I'm gonna put it on average.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Tonentino. Oh, Arnaud, a classic broche boulette. Typical Belgian boulette. It's like
it's just trash.
It's like
all the rest of the meat
put together in a ball, and then they cook it, and then they slice it in like small pieces. It's called boulette. You can also order it in the friture. So we got onions, some eggs,
tomatoes,
and then some healthy shit. For me, it's like very good.
For me, it's not like.
Okay, Arnaud.
The same guy. Don't like it. You want to take it?
It's very good for me.
What do you think it is?
Godlike. Boner alert.
Do you remember Andy, the inventor of the fries? Do you enjoy broodjes?
Of course I enjoy broodjes. Get a roast beef béarnaise, yeah?
Bye-bye.
Roast beef béarnaise. The favorite one of Andy from Fritco, the inventor of the fries. Steak sliced in really thin layers. And then béarnaise sauce.
I'm not a béarnaise man.
But it fits well with roast beef.
It's good.
Good? Andy will like spit in my fries next time you see him.
Damn, that was good. Godlike.
What is your favorite broodje?
Martino with anchovies.
Ah, six, that, anchovies, right. So this is called the Roma. Average for me.
Average.
The Italian. Parma ham with olive oil and then mozzarella. Good because it is better than the Roma.
Yeah, way better.
Tonen Persic tuna salad with peach.
I think this is pretty good.
It's good.
All right, applaud this one for tuna because they broke the average barrier.
The last one of round two is called...
Arnaud, are you ready?
This one is called Broodje Gezond.
Get that shit out of here.
It's just vegetables. Look, I'm gonna be honest. Broodje Gezond, why are you even eating a broodje? Like...
It's like I'm eating grass now.
No. Trash.
This is for the cows. Hi, cow. I have something slightly better than grass.
Underneath trash.
It's a new tier. It's called For the Cows. Broodje Gezond. All right, so we've tasted around 22, 23 different broodjes. But there's only one left that I could eat in a hole after eating a shitload of other broodjes. It is... Broodje Américain, alstublieft. So this is broodje Américain, but with extra Américain. If you press on it, Martino, it's like a bougie Américain.
It's not better.
This is like
this
culture.
Is life. This is Belgium. Yeah.
Oh. Ah, it's so good. Like, Américain préparé is the most beautiful thing that has ever been made. I think this is it.
It's okay. Américain can do that.
The ultimate broodjes tier list. We have tasted the top 23 best sold broodjes in this broodje sack. Let's go through all the tiers. We had to create a tier for broodje gezond because it doesn't make any sense. We have nothing in trash, nothing in bad. One in meh, gerookte zalm. It's not my thing.
It's not wow.
In average, lesla, tonen piquant, salsa porky, keep Hawaii, tonentino, and Roma. Sorry, you're in average. Average is still good. I'm also in this list. Do you see me complaining? Then we have good, eiersla, surim. creamy, keep Andalus saxophone, roast beef béarnaise, Italian, and then tuna persic. Mm. Then we go to the very good. Those are like the classics. Keep curry, chicken samurai, scampi lok. This is actually the revelation of the video.
It's like the rishi sauce.
Yeah, like the rishi, yeah. And then Paris, aka panis. And then we go to the godlike, of course. The ones that make you go
erection mode.
Martino, of course. Mos, roche boulette. And then the god of all the godlikes is America, as to believe. We'd like to end this video on a positive note. First of all, I want to give you some advice. If you're visiting Belgium and you go to Brussels to eat a motherfucking waffle,
fuck you.
Get the fuck out of here.
Ring finger.
Guess where you can go?
Your asshole.
Yeah. If you enjoy watching this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. If this video gets 30,000 likes, I will tattoo Brocha American.
Really?
Should I?
Yeah.
Okay, if this video gets 30,000 likes, I will tattoo something about Brocha American. Subscribe, join the family.
New merch coming soon.
I'm plugging it, but
it's gonna be cute. And then most importantly, Arno, please take it away.
Broad notification squad. All
right.
Thank you very much. It was nice.
All right. Okay. Goodbye, Arno.
Can you drop me at the station?